Welcome back to Nighthawk Gaming. Today we are having a look at Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 as we wait for the imminent release of Modern Warfare 3 onto modern consoles. We'll duck back as we have done in the past onto the older platform, so an Xbox 360 version of Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, playing it on a Series X console. We will load it up and have had a look. So I've played one game that we managed to get into on the Xbox here, just to test it out, see if there was anyone still playing it. There was, so let's jump back in. It only took about 20 odd seconds to find a match, so hopefully we find ourselves in a very similar position again as we jump into it. Seven more players. Although the ping is right there, there we go. But we have managed to find ourselves a game. Oh, it was a little bit there as we jumped in. But again, this same has been played in the, World of War. It was one of the last ones we did play. And being a slightly friendly predator missile incoming. Older game, the modern player is a bit smaller. Very quick in, very quick out for that one there. So let's see. So let's go. Karachi is the next one. So we create a title. Good new title. Instead of FNG. It's been years since I played these, so I don't. Some of those little funny things you. Intermission almost done there, and we'll get back into it. As I said, it's been years since I've done any of these old 360 and PS3 versions of Call of Duties.
Fuck.
So these ones I'll do smaller maps. Just as annoying as any of you guys, you won't be able to push streaks. Respawning, I should say, it very much depends on you get that sort of one or three or four deaths in a row. It's rather annoying. Here we go. Five kills, not great, but in any event. It's interesting to see that it's still fairly quick and easy to get into a game. Well, you can see there you're playing against level 70 players there that have obviously been putting quite a fair bit of time into 20 odd seconds to get into the next batch. But the fact that you can still jump into a game, you know, would have to be 15 years since it was released or thereabouts, and still get in and be able to play a game of multiplayer that the servers are still live. Much like we did with, as I mentioned before, World at War, that we managed to jump into that one and have a bit of a crack at it as well. So let's get ourselves into this one. What do we end up with? Wasteland.
Team deathmatch. Let's do this.
And I have to say, it doesn't matter which Call of Duty you play, unless you're
changing Mac.
On a fairly regular basis, you are going to struggle sometimes. A big sniper map, it's wide open. So this is why I like that smaller maps, you get straight into it. Is the constant combat through the game. You spend all this time trying to find the enemies and get up on them, but then, as luck would have it, it's not there. So there you go.
UAV online.
Where did that come from?
Friendly Predator missile inbound.
Oh, Jesus.
UAV online.
That's the main. Well, that wasn't a sniper. He just came around the corner. To you. Starting out, you haven't unlocked a lot of the
throwing stun grenade. Enemy carrier is incoming. Target neutralized.
Yeah, we just got this. Some of those things are sort of disappear. Target acquired. Enemy carrier is incoming. Battle away and slowly.
Enemy harrier is incoming.
Level up and upgrade yourself so you can get to that point where you are unlocking some of those weapons. Can I unlock them?
In the lead.
That's one of the things that you forget as well, playing the old Xbox 360s. The browns and the greys and the red hair doesn't make it seem what's going on. And sometimes it seems when I played World at War, they didn't have these sort of kill streaks. And you can see I'm flying there, 3 kills. Absolutely flying. Let's go one more. What about Karachi? Let's see, so you can skip that one. I think that was the one I ended up doing before in the first game that I trialled it to see if you could get any online games running. Four votes to skip, 680, come on. Two more. I'm sure you can see the on the list of players on the right there. Herdy23. I'm not sure how you passed your clan name past the moderators, but here there you are, I suppose. Good luck to you. Six votes to skip. One more needed. Vote pass. There we go. We are skipping. Just as the match was about to begin, and we're going to the scrapyard. Scrapyard. I don't think I played this one either, so let's see how we go with that. And that's the other thing as well, the perks and that's...
Team deathmatch.
The shield and the...
Let's do this. Tossing stun grenade. In the lead. Target neutralized. Target down. We've lost the lead.
Horrendous. All right, let's change that. Let's go to... Go with that, see if we can get some kills with him. I swear to God that happens more often than not. You sit there, the moment you turn away from where you're looking at someone.
Reloading!
That's my creep up.
Friendly predator missile inbound.
Steady was. Ballistic damage. Kill 16 deaths. So there you go. Well, there you go. There's a few games of Modern Warfare 2 played on the Xbox 360 version, played on the Xbox Series X. It does run pretty well. It just, as I mentioned a couple of times, it still does have that grey, browny sort of tinge to the graphic settings, which I find somewhat difficult to play with. You know, clearly, you know, not hampering some people that much. You can see with their skill sets there, but having not played this particular one for, as I said, at least 10 years, it does have a bit of a challenge getting yourself back up to the level. But in any event, that'll get us through today. And then we've only got a couple of days until Modern Warfare 3 drops, and we can jump into the multiplayer for that. And we will certainly be having that on the channel as well. So make sure you keep an eye out for it. And if you've enjoyed this one, consider liking and subscribing to the channel. It certainly does help us out. And we'll be back with more videos soon. Thanks for watching.